Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can calculate address of 2D array. So basically, if you want to calculate address of 2D array, so we have two methods. First is row measure, and second one is column measure. Right, so let's say we have a 2D array of dimension 3 by 4. So these are 3 rows and these are 4 columns, right? So if we calculate addresses based on algorithm, so in case of algorithm we consider like indexes are 1, 2, 3 for rows and 1, 2, 3, 4 for columns, right? But if you want to calculate address for any programming language, so then these indexes start from 0. So accordingly, you need to calculate, right? So right now, I am considering that this is first row, this is second row, this is third row, first column, second column, third column, and fourth column, right? So now let's calculate address with the help of row measure model, right? So I'm going to write a formula. So if we want to calculate address for this dimension, I representing row index and j representing column index, and A is a matrix. So let's say this is A, which is 2D array of 3 by 4 dimension. Then BA stands for base address. W stands for word size, or you can say size of a particular block. Then N into, so N is representing number of columns here. Then I minus 1, right? And then J minus 1. So this is row index minus 1, this is column index minus 1, and with the help of this formula we can calculate the address. So let's say base address of this 2D array is 1000. So beginning address of this matrix is 1000, and we are going to calculate address for this location, second row, third column. So it means we need to calculate address for this location, right? And word size is 2 bytes. It means each location is having 2 bytes of memory, right? So if this beginning location is 1000, so next location address will be 1002. So 1000 and 1001 will be reserved for this. And after 2 addresses, next location address will be 1002, and so on. So we need to calculate address for a particular location through this formula, because if your 2D array is having lots of rows and columns, so you cannot calculate address by going to each location, right? So you need a formula where you can place the values and automatically particular address will be available. So now if we want to identify address for this location with the help of row measure order, so this is base address, W is 2, then N is representing number of columns. So here you can see number of columns are 4. So I am putting 4 here, multiplied. I is row, so 2 minus 1 plus 3 minus 1. 3 is column, so it is here, right? So now 1000 is the base address, then 4 into 1 plus 2, right? So this will be calculated. So now 4 into 1 is 4 and plus 2. So next we can do this. So it will be 1000 plus 2 into, sorry, 6. Now 6 into 2 is 12, and it will be added into 1000. So it is 1012. So now we are going to calculate addresses manually. So it is 1000. Next possible address will be 1002, then 1004, 1006, 1008, 1010 and 1012. So here you can see we are having correct address with the help of this formula. So this formula is basically related to row measure order. So it means if you are storing your 2D array in a row measure order, it means first this row will be stored in memory, then this row, and so on. Right? Another method of storing 2D array is column measure. So in case of column measure order, first this column is stored in memory, then this column, and then this column. So now we are going to modify this formula so that we can calculate address with the help of column measure order. So to apply this, I need to change this value. So M will be replaced with M, I will be replaced with J, and J will be replaced with I. So this is for column measure order, right? So here M is now representing number of rows, right? So let's say if we want to calculate this address, so I am erasing these. So again, we want to calculate address for this location. So now you need to remember that memory is stored based on columns. So first this column will be stored in memory, then this column, and then this column. So now we need to put the values accordingly. Right, so I am erasing these things. And as per this formula, now we need to put the values. So here you can see base address is 1000. So I am putting 1000 as base address. Now W is 2, so plus 2. Then M is representing number of rows. So number of rows are 3 multiplied with J minus 1. J is 3. So 3 minus 1 plus I is 2. 2 minus 1. So now this is the formula. Then 1000 plus 2. So here 3 into 2 plus 1. So if we calculate this, so it will be 6 plus 1, 7, 7 into 2, 14. So final outcome will be this, 1014, right? So now let's calculate this. So it is 1000, it will be 1002, then 1004, 1006, 1008, 1010, 1012, and 1014. So you can see if we store this 2D array in column measure order, so this will be the address for this. So this way, I hope you understood both the formulas related to row measure order and column measure order. So remember one thing, whenever we want to calculate address, so we can store 2D array in two ways. One is row measure order, second is column measure order. So accordingly, you need to calculate the address of a particular location. So I hope you understood how we can calculate address of a particular location through row measure order as well as through column measure order with the help of formula. And if you want to watch more videos related to these data structures and algorithms, you can go to description of this video where you will find links of playlists. So you can follow them. Thank you for watching this video.